need somebody like me.
This is a review of a certain dividend stock na based on 2022 dividend rate and it at its current price, eh, nasa top 20 siya, highest dividend yield in the PSE or listed sa PSE. So we're going to take a look at the current fundamentals of this company and see at what price ko siya bibilhin that can give me that desired or at least 10% year on year for the next few years. This content is brought to you by the sponsors of my channel, Patreon and YouTube. Become a sponsor, get access to my world-class top-level stock research tool na ginagamit ko mismo. I use this to help myself build a quality portfolio. Yung pwede kong tulugan, hindi yung portfolio na iniiyakan. And this stock is a small cap stock na si Crown Asia Chemicals Corporation. So, malit lang siya. Less than 1 billion in market cap. Pwedeng-pwedeng i-acquire ng mga malalaking companies dyan kung trip nila. So, ito yung latest article about kay Crown. Kung saan, yung kanyang performance ng 2022. So, yung kanyang net income is 228 million. And a revenue of 1.76 billion. So, hindi ganon kalaki yung kanyang growth ng 2022. So, performance was partly affected by more robust credit evaluation and partly affected by higher operating cost. So, nag-declare sila ng dividends recently which is a little bit lower compared sa declaration nila ng 2022. Crown said it looks forward to a better 2023 daw. Okay, with the recovery of construction activities and infrastructure expenditures, both public and private, especially as the current administration advocates PPP in pursuance of the Build program. So, si Crown Pipes daw, sila yung supplier ng Metro Manila Subway, North-South Commuter Railway, Skyway 3 Extension, CBEX, Wawa Dam, to name a few, has upcoming several years of revenue streams from major infrastructure projects. Di ba? Kung ganun pala dapat, nagpapacquire ka na lang eh. That will impact Philippine economy, progress and development, benefiting several sectors and generations to come. So, ang kagandahan kasi kay Crown is that looks like nag-innovate sila. So, may mga experiment sila na mga product na kapag dyan, may na-discover sila na medyo mag-hit. Di ba? Uy, di ba? Could become a massive growth driver for this company. So, here's the growth overview for Crown. So, under 1 billion in market cap. So, ako gusto ko yung mga ganyan, maliliit. Di ba? Kasi sa mga maliliit, so, ayan yung medyo minsan tahimik sila and then later on, bigla na lang puputok. Diba? Pero kapag maliliit, gusto ko yung namimigay ng dividends talaga. Para while waiting, diba, you still have that cash flows through dividends na marireceive mo, na pwede mong i-reinvest ng i-reinvest. So, revenues increasing, net income is increasing, cash flows increasing. So, liquid assets increasing. Meron silang 250 million right now. Free cash flows increasing. So, wala gaano utang, which is good yan for small companies. Kailangan hindi sila aggressive umutang. Kailangan they're well capitalized. Kaya nilang i-sustain yung kanilang business operation. Shares outstanding flat. Debt to EBITDA, almost zero kasi nga wala yung anong utang yung company na to. So basically it's an all check company with a return on invested capital of more than 10%. So quarterly performance, revenue going down, net income going down, cash flows going up. So dividends going down, kasi 2021 to eh. 2022, malaki ulit yung dividends nila. And then, 2023, medyo malaki pa rin. So, ang pinaka-highest na binibigay nila dati is 56 million. Napakadaling bayaran. So, 56 million, that's just less than 25%, di ba? Ng kanilang net income, cash flows, and free cash flow. So, kayang-kayang bayaran. So, ito yung dividend yield history ng company. So, 6.25% last year. Na nagkaroon ng a little bit of decrease this year. Mga less than 1% of decrease. So, parang binalik niya lang sa kanyang 2019. So, 5.63 na dividend yield. So, madali lang bayaran to, di ba? Ayan o, 55 million lang yung kailangan nilang bayaran. Still, less than 25% ng kanilang cash flows and free cash flow. So, siguro nagdadahan-dahan lang to na maybe baka kailangan nila yung pera for some reinvestment to their business. Now, let's take a look at the fair valuation of this company. So, nag-grow siya ng 6.89% year over year. For the past 5 years, na pag na-maintain niya yan, 2.78. So, 2.78, dito ba yan, no? Di ba? Babalik siya dito. Grossly undervalued. Ngayon, nagde-decline siya na quarterly basis, 1.35, which I don't think mag-continue yung decline na yan. Actually, for the past 2 years, flat sila. Ayan o. So, yung flat, yun yung much better definition sa company to right now. Na kapag flat siya for the next few years, 2.14 still grossly undervalued. Dito ba yan? Babalik siya dito. And this is what I like about this company. Undervalued right now and paying good dividends. Na while waiting na mag-appreciate to or i-acquire ng mga malalaking company or mga conglomerate, diba? Tanggap lang ng tanggap ng dividends or maybe biglang pumutok to kasi less than 1 billion, madaling pangatin yung mga ganito. And that's my take on Crown. So it's very healthy na small company unlike other small companies out there na papangit or ang dudugyot ng kanilang fundamentals and hindi ba namimigay ng dividends. Eto, diba? Malinis, undervalued, pays consistent dividends year over year. That's it. Thank you and bye-bye. Like, subscribe.